All right, here we go. The main event, Frank Trigg and Robbie Lawler. This fight started off yesterday, essentially the hype with the Kiss shit heard around the world. We will explain that in a moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for your Steinlager main event. Are you ready? I said, are you ready? This bout is for the world middleweight championship. It is scheduled for five-minute rounds. Coming out of the blue corner, fighting out of Davenport, Iowa, representing Miletich Fighting Systems, please welcome Ruthless Robbie Lawler! Coming out of the red corner, fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, and representing J-Sect R1 Gym, Frank Twinkle Toes Trigg!
So we mentioned the Kiss heard around the world. It was during the weigh-in yesterday, and there was a point in the weigh-in in which the two fighters, Trigg and Lawler, were asked to pose down. Lawler stepped up into Trigg's face. What did Trigg do? He smooched him on the lips, gave him a quick kiss. Lawler backed up, was not happy about it, as you see right there. Trigg basically banking on Lawler being upset, being fired up, coming out, because we have seen in the past Lawler coming out fired up and maybe not fighting his best. Trigg also saying that this fight will undoubtedly end violently.
He always pushes the fight right here, and this is what he needed to do, take the fight to the ground early, because Robbie Lawler is an excellent wrestler. Trigg's more, I guess, experienced in wrestling than Robbie is, but Robbie has some devastating power in his hands.
Robbie Lawler just needs that one bomb. He lands that one bomb, and he can end the fight just like that.
It got to that point in the weigh-ins that the promoter, T.J. John, thought he had to run in to separate him because they thought they were going to throw blows right there.
Lawler connecting here on his back. Some of these going to the back of Trigg's dome. Yuji Shimada not concerned with it until that one right there. Lawler trying to become the first time, two-time world middleweight champion in the Icon ring. Trigg is the title holder. Trigg won it by defeating Mayhem Miller via TKO.
Robbie using a butterfly guard here. Is it good to kind of elevate, create some space? If he can pummel both hands inside, he can possibly sit up and create a scramble.
That's it. Yuji will stand him up, much to the pleasure of the Blaisdell crowd. They're up and up again. Lawler came with the jab, Trigg with the takedown.
Trigg got in deep on that one, finished well. It's exactly the fight that Trigg wants to be. Quick takedowns, keep the fight on the ground, trying to grind him out.
It was not long ago that Trigg, according to his own records, was just lying around the house, eating potato chips, getting fat, he said. And then TJ Thompson, promoter here for Icon, called him up and kept trying to convince him to fight for the middleweight title. He said, you know what, I'm going to give it a try. And he claims he has refound that love. He has refound that passion.
Now he says he fights for the love of it. He always had that time, 230 pounds. Nice takedown. Textbook wrestling technique right here by Frank Trigg.
Beautifully done. The champ with the top position once more. Got to get free for that quick left. 2.5 minutes left in this round. One five-minute rounds. A grueling distance fight. Always the case for a title fight.
Robbie wants to pace himself as well. He comes up too hard. It's a long 5-minute rounds.
I think that may have been what Trigg was banking on when he did pull off yesterday. Trigg landing some punches. keeping the pressure on, ruthless Robbie Lawler.
2 minutes.
Robbie doing a good job keeping that butterfly guard. Also prevents Troy from putting a lot of pressure on him as well.
Good left by Trigg. Trigg is so strong. We saw what he was able to do against Mayhem Miller, basically throwing him around in ways that we have never seen Mayhem Miller thrown around.
Trigg will wear you down. He just keeps on grinding out the takedowns, chopping you down, chopping you down.
So is the science of trigonomics.
Nice little sweep by Robin to stand up. His head's trapped.
A lot of knees to the face there from Trigg. And Trigg just working up and down, applying his scheme.
Textbook switches right here. Every time he gets up, he goes shoot for a double. It's the first time actually in the fight that Robbie has a decent position on Trigg.
He wants to let his hands fly. Trigg has not allowed him to do that for the most part here in this round one.
Trigg's done a good job of getting head control, head positioning, switching top to bottom.
Keeping Lawler in the defensive mode the entire time. There's an abdomen shot from Lawler, and that can ring somebody's bell easily. Take the air out of him.
Like Robbie, I wonder if Robbie's a little gassed here.
30 seconds. Up to go in round one. There's a leg chop from Trigg. Trying for the combo. Made some noise, but Trigg right back at him. Combo of his own.
Hands up, Frank, please. Hands up, baby.
Well, looks like Trigg is switching gears here. Nice switch. Go up top, throw a couple bombs.
To the ropes they come.
And go back to the takedown.
Last few seconds of this round one. There's the horn. Trigg mixing it up so well in that round one.
Perfect strategy, perfect execution of that strategy. Trigg wanted to take this fight to the ground as soon as possible. He did that. He started crying down Robbie. He didn't have a chance to kind of get off his punches. After the round, when he starts wearing him down, he starts opening him up, throwing some punches, opening up that opportunity to take him back down to the ground.
We've seen a couple of times,
makes it very difficult for Robbie to fire off anything with of value as far as the punching.
But ultimately, it always goes back to the old adage when it comes to ruthless Robbie Lawler. He only needs that one. He just needs that one.
You got to think, too, that Robbie's still a kid. He's very, very young. See if that kind of weighs into it. Robbie's also very devastating with that left leg kick to the head.
Really doing. Throw it. Could see it and hear it.
When he comes in, nothing to do.
Trigg coming with a couple of fists. Jab from Lawler to the eye of Trigg. Trigg had to wipe off perhaps some perspiration that got into the eyeball. Trigg pulling Robbie down.
This is where his trainer with John Lewis is going to come in. John Lewis is an excellent jiu-jitsu and MMA trainer.
Under one arm, over the other arm, under the face.
Let's see what John Lewis taught Frank Trigg off his back.
Trigg talked a lot throughout the week coming into this fight about his condition and how well conditioned he considers himself to be.
This fight, he didn't look as ripped as he did with, oh, nice.
Lawler got him with that one. Comes back up top. Goes body and then head again.
Robbie's creating a lot of space first. Allows him to generate a lot of power with those punches.
Some sweat flying there, but not a purely clean shot from Robbie Lawler.
Yeah, hold him tight.
I was saying the Trigg didn't look as ripped as he did against Jason Mayhem Miller, but Robbie Lawler, man, this is the best I've ever seen him look. He looks ripped.
In fact, when he weighed in, yeah, yesterday. He was wearing sneakers, weighed in well under the 185 mark. He was very confident he would make weight, and he did.
Looks like Robbie's getting a little sloppy with his hands here.
How about the exchange there? Good right from Lawler. Trigg reaches. You're right, Lawler. As far as aesthetically speaking, he looks incredible. Similar to what we saw when he first defeated Nico Vitale to win the title.
Nice scramble away. Single leg there. Robbie Lawler. This is what Robbie wants to do. Defend those takedowns. Start chipping him out. Nice right. Left hand there.
He's going to shove Trigg into the corner. Trigg coming with the knees. So wily, the veteran. Has been through the big left press over.
Robbie needs to open up and start landing those punches. Trigg did a good job of recovering his guard here. You see his eyes got huge after that blow and he landed on his back.
2 minutes.
He got that one. Can he come up with one more? They stand up again.
Trigg's hands are low.
So close. He can feel it. He can sense it. Under a minute to go here in round two. And Yuji will stand him up. Yuji Shimada. And he's going to have Trigg looked at. They're going to stop it with 40 seconds left in round two. Shimada wants the doc to check out Frank Trigg's nose.
And both fighters probably needed this break to catch their breath. Robbie Lawler looked away, kind of gave a smile. Look, he's just smiling in the corner right here.
How about the onslaught of ruthless Robbie Lawler in this second round?
Phenomenal work. This is the game plan that Robbie Lawler wanted to do. Stuff those takedowns, let his hands go.
Lawler continues to come with it. Trigg appears
30 seconds!
There's his uppercuts by Lawler.
Lawler thinking finish. Lawler thinking title.
Trigg
trying to mount a comeback. Two champions in their own right. Lawler, a former champ. Trigg, the current champ. Fighting like champions.
You guys, the
show. Oh, on their feet. This is not the fight. The fight that we expected.
What Trigg said in the week leading up to this fight, he said that this would not go past three rounds. We talked about the science of trigonomics in that second round. We saw the law of Lawler.
Nice sprawl and brawl technique.
Round three. Coming up. Lawler could smell it in that second round. Now can Trigg reach even deeper down into his psyche, down into his character?
Robbie's taking away that jab right to Trigg's nose.
His first couple jabs getting through cleanly, too. Another one. Trigg closing the gap. Trigg looks somewhat worn here, Mike.
Still stalking, though. It's still stalking Robbie.
2-3-2, stay in. Fight in, Fred.
And Trigg going on the offensive. Trigg starting to connect, and he has a heavy hand. Trigg turning things around.
Robbie's rolling with those punches, though. A lot of him's not getting in. Maybe he's trying to have Trigg empty his gas tank out early. Good hits by Robbie. Pushes Trigg down to the guard.
Lawler trying to pass there.
He needs to cover that leg. He's a good job covering the leg, trying to try that arm up, open up Trigg's head.
Lawler's corner. All the boys at Militant Fighting System telling him, sit on that leg.
And Lawler passes right here. Excellent position.
Opportunity knocking here for Robbie Lawler.
Good job by Trigg recovering that guard.
Lawler doing his best not to let him. We thought it would be an all-out battle, an all-out war. Trigg and Lawler to the end.
3 minutes.
And Robbie has been content with letting Trigg come to him. And as you said, looks like he's trying to roll with those punches, but very dangerous. Rolling the dice.
He's roping it open, but those punches are getting in from Trigg. He's not totally blocking them.
Good left there by Trigg. That one definitely getting through. How about Frank Trigg? How many others could have taken the punishment passed out by Robbie Lawler and still be ticking, still be going?
Robbie fires back with a left.
That uppercut has been devastating here. Blood splashing into the face of Yuji Shimada.
Come on, baby, put your fight on.
These two fighters at the very brink of exhaustion. Left by Lawler, a right jab. And Trigg stays in there with the takedown. Hangs in there. This has become a blood fest.
Great. Wizard by Lawler, come back, scramble back up.
Both fighters bleeding profusely.
Trigg trying to use that head control.
And Trigg dripping hardcore from that nose. Lawler covered in what is probably Trigg's blood.
Definitely. Trigg again is bleeding like a pig. And every time Lawler keeps on flicking out that jab, he's aiming for that nose to keep that blood running. That's going to hinder the breathing.
1:39 on the clock here in round three. It is frozen in time for the moment. Trigg said this fight would not go past round three. He said one or the other will happen. Either he will knock Lawler out in round three or Lawler will knock him out in round three. It will not go further than that.
We've got a minute and 39 seconds for his prediction to come true.
A lot of time taken. Both fighters using that rest to their advantage. Another jab that splashes the blood.
Nice one, two.
Another jab from Lawler, peppering that nose. Left that connects. Trigg hanging in there. Big right, that one didn't quite get there. Big left from Trigg, tried to follow it up, but Robbie getting out of the way. Robbie looks fresher. Robbie looks more determined. Robbie looks like he's on the prowl. Trigg, ever the warrior, hanging in there.
1 minute.
He's still stalking Robbie. He's taking some shots, but he keeps on pressing the action.
Hands down and go in. Follow your
Another solid left from Lawler.
Anybody said that Trigg can't take a punch has to watch this fight, because Trigg has been taking some great punches by Robbie Lawler, still standing there.
Yeah, they should eat their words the way Trigg is eating some of these punches. How about the knee by Trigg? Trigg putting together a little rally.
30 seconds.
30 seconds
remaining here in round number three. But it's become a brutal, bloody war between these two consummate champions.
1-6! Nice slap, and that sneaks into the chin of Trigg.
Lawler with an uppercut. That uppercut hurt Trigg in the second round, may have done so again there. But Trigg hanging in there continuously. There's the horn of round three. How Trigg is still going is beyond me.
He's just a machine right now. And every time he gets hurt, he's still stalking Robbie Lawler. When you hit a guy with all your might, the guy stalks you, it has to affect you.
Well, the prediction that Frank Trigg threw out there as far as this fight not getting past three rounds, that was wrong. But everybody in the Blaisdell happy that he was wrong, because this is going to a fourth round, and this has been fun to watch.
Definitely, these guys' tanks have been tested, their hearts have been tested, their chins have been tested. You can see both fighters just kind of exchanging. Trigg is kind of stalking. Robbie trying to roll with the punches there, but a lot of those punches started landing. Robbie probably the more accurate puncher. A lot more power on his punches, but a lot fewer punches.
But to see Frank Trigg putting forth the effort despite some of the blows he has taken, simply amazing. This is what combat fighting, this is what mixed martial arts is all about. They'll stand toe-to-toe again. Lawler continues to connect, although not with the might that he did on some of the flurries in early round three and back in round two.
1-6.
Keep that ass.
Keep
it. Trigg again.
Oh, Trigg peppering him.
Putting together a combination. And Trigg goes back to what he did in round one, mixing things up.
Still a lot of power left in Robbie Lawler.
Yeah, that was all leg strength right there.
How's that, baby? How's that?
1-6.
It's you, Frank. How are you?
1-6.
1-6 is following in. Yeah, my dad. Follow
it
in.
Keep it up. Keep it up.
They're hurting
him out. Now Trigg continues to push and take this fight to Lawler.
Trigg measuring with that jab and coming in.
Both fighters look like their tanks are running on fumes.
Trigg running on hard right now.
Another big left by Lawler.
Nice combination there.
Trigg coming back with a combo of his own. This has been the theme. When it appears as though Trigg could take no more, Trigg comes back and delivers some punishment. There's a combo, there it is! And this one is over! Robbie Lawler returns to icon glory in the middleweight division.
What an explosive end to this incredible fight.
And Trigg still down in the corner. A valiant effort, a courageous effort. But in the end, Robbie Lawler was too much. Robbie Lawler, too explosive. Robbie Lawler, now the champ again.
He's just so exhausted. He looks in very, very bad shape.
Winner by knockout.
Doctors right there checking on him.
Ruthless Robbie Lawler.
Gets his, catch his breath. He don't want to go on his mouth. He's taking off. He just wants maximum air to get some air in. Spewing blood.
Well, trig being tended to, but you're right. Right now, he's just trying to get as much air as possible. Let's watch the finish of this fight here. This was devastating. This was brutal. Watch this last punch right there. Definitely a punch that was unnecessary in terms of the outcome of the fight. Trigg was
Robbie,
definitely out before that last
you
punch.
You want the first middleweight to hold the belt, lose it, and come back and reclaim it. That was a hell of a fight. Maybe the best we've ever seen in 12 years of Icon. The greatest fight I've ever seen. Tell us about it.
I was hurting from my back. I was hitting him right over behind the ear and hurt him pretty good. And then he just kept coming and coming, and I could hit him with more than 3 shots at a time. And in that last round, I just hit him with some combos.
Looked like first round, he was getting you with the takedowns. And then later on in the fight, you just stuffed everything. How'd you do that?
First of all, he took me down. I kind of let him because I knew that's what he was going to do. Went straight to my butterfly, and he couldn't pass it, and that's what's up.
And you stepped on the scale for this fight at 182. Now, normally, you have a hard time making weight. You came in, this is the leanest we've seen you ever. You just came in hungry for this fight? Is that what this is about?
I was very hard trained, and I actually came in at 84 with my shoes on. Thank you.
That knockout again.
Just gotta say, Robbie.
So right there, the fight was over.
Was over.
Eugene trying to reach in there.
Just keep hitting him.
Quite
coming.
Pull Robbie off. Before that last blow.
Oh man, he was hitting me with some devastated knees.
And an uppercut.
Rolling with him. And I knew I had to put 2 and 3, 4 or 5 shots together, and that's when I finished the win.
Now, are you ready to come back and defend this belt? Now we've got Cerruto in the mix. Mayhem just knocked the guy out. Nico Vitale calls me every now and then and asks when he gets to come back and fight again. Who do you want to fight next?
I don't know. I'm not too worried about any of those guys. If I come in shape, I'm knocking them out. What's up?
Right on. Everybody give it up. The Icon middleweight world champion, Ruthless Robbie Lawler.